Brooklyn kicked the ball from two steps. Come on there, man. To the downtown East London, he fired deep. It's crumbs.
I wouldn't know about that. I'm not. Program for the next generation. The program is a good teacher himself. You listen, it has to come from himself. You understand? It's got to come from him. It's got to find the God spirit within you. The man to do right, because remember in the beginning, God deposited his wisdom in man. He put himself in man, and what man must do now is dig deep within himself and find God and manifest God. And he's already in us, all of us as a people. Because the Bible says, as it was in the beginning, so shall it be in the ending. And we're in that process right now. And the youth are the future. That's why the world today is trying to destroy the young youth. That's why they call them gangs. And because the youth love gangs, it's like a word. Words carry weight.
Exactly.
And literally, they want to be in a gang. They don't use nothing like a group of. Yes, they use a gang. So now you've got areas where the brothers think, well, our gang versus a gang down the road, and then you go to war. It's all a teaching.
I'm going to chime in real quick though, because this one, he's stand himself more correctly. He's on a good path already. So basically, he's telling you, you know, none of the stuff you can. You're going to be more inquisitive. You made the inquiry already. Every time I see you, we build nice, and then you're a book, boom. You know what I'm saying? I tell you, what I tell you every time I see you, don't fight your teachers, just simply say, look, Mr. Principal, whatever, that ain't so. Question them nicely, don't come with the attitude, and you wake other people up in the class also. We know you're going for hell, because guess what? When we was your age, school meant hell. Like, literally, school degree, it meant hell. And class is the Roman answer. Class is the highest degree in the Roman army. This is military warfare they're going through right now. You're going through. But I don't want to change places, but we're going to help you along the way. Because you're going to like turn around right now. We done our bit, but we still got a few more to do. Everyone's got different positions to play. So you see all different people representing different societies or different nations, but at the end of the day, we're all one. So you may see like the Wampians out here, Kamatuckians out here, Nation Clowns out here, Wizards out here, but we all one at the end of the day. Because when a man comes to put his foot on your neck, he ain't saying, yo, you 5%er, you Moorish Nation, you Rastafari. He ain't trying to hear that. He like, yo, you all the same copper skin tone. I'm going to take you all out for the food, for the sex, for the media. Boom, we get it from like every single direction. You know what I'm saying? So when we say there's war out here, it doesn't mean you're going to pick up a knife, pick up a gun, do something illegal, and put your ass in jail. If you're going to put your ass in jail, you ain't no benefit to the next generation. You ain't no benefit to your mom, your pa, your niece, your nephew, to none of us. The real front line is out here. It ain't where you're from, it's where you're at. Where you're at is a mental state. These are all states of minds. You follow? The UK, you begin to learn, it's not even a country. It's a corporation. The US is not a country. It's a corporation. These are states of mind. These are fictitious states of mind. So our state of mind is that we have to be collective.
Unity is the key.
Love the unity. As we move on to the next brother right here, this is unity right here. Can I be unity, whatever you want to call it? No separation. Brother, explain who you represent.
My name is Brother Yashma. I am in the spirit of our ancestors. Like the brother said, that all of us are collective consciousness, just different aspects of who we are. Everything with spirituality is who we are, is what we are created. And at will we could be any one of those spiritualities.
Let's chime in real quick. I'm gonna let you build. He touched on a point in the world when he said he represent the ancestors. Now a lot of people say, yeah, I want to be like the descendants. Check this out, the metaphysics, right? I love my descendants. However, my descendants are descended. That's a spiraling down effect. I'm trying to be like my ascendants. I'm trying to be like Malcolm Marcus. They ascended. I'd rather be like my ascendants. All of this is an ascension. We are light beings passing through on a human physical experience on this plane, not planet, this plane of thoughts. So we're trying to be like our ancestors. That's a beautiful thing. Because we don't witness death. Death is a European concept. We like babies, kid. We don't die, we multiply. I know you heard the joke. I'm making it. This is real, though. This is real matter physics. Follow. Sorry to show your bill. I just wanted to touch on that.
Yeah, like the brother say that. Like the brother said a while ago, that we don't have an expiry date. We have always been. We will always be. All who that came after us, like the Caucasian, the Chinese, all those people came after. They came after us, and we have been the first. We've always been the first, and we will never be a last first, because we are all that is. Without us, there was nothing.
So it's time and illusion.
Time and illusion.
And time is illusion because they gave us their concept of time. Prominently, a guy called Gregory took it over from the Julian calendar, who's Julian Caesar, where they call themselves gods and very egotistical. So now you've got the Gregorian calendar that everyone's co-signing. I refuse to co-sign this level of ignorance. I'm not co-signing it. I don't recognize Christmas, New Year, whatever. It's just another day to me, you follow? So we say like Happy New Year and all that. We're different times, two different worlds, clashing with a different paradigm. Knowledge runs things. Right now, the main thing taking us out is through the foods. I'm tired of getting the call. I know you've all heard this call, you get the phone call, some brother passed away because of diabetes. My mother left this plane 4 years ago. Diabetes complications. One of my best friends, cancer complications. My sister had a womb taken out, fiber complications. Yo, these things never existed when we ran Kemet and Nubia. These things I never heard of.
Are you
until we started.
I'll come back in a minute.
Eating and consuming Eurocentric foods and taking the Eurocentric mentalities. We don't have these illnesses and diseases in our communities. You know what I'm saying?
Peace, man.
But right now, everyone's catching that. Why is that? We got to eradicate that. Come on, diet. And the word diet ties in with your deities. And you hear the words, where I mentioned the ancestors before, your ancestors connect with you through what you're eating, right? Like the wild part or the dolphin part, they're all as one, right? Well, your ancestors connect through you with a metaphysics, something called alleles. That's A-L-L-E-L-S-F. Alleles. They connect with your genealogy. You're eating foods that your DNA can't comprehend or compute. Follow? So most of you compromise the integrity of your divinity via your RNA and your DNA, and yet these Chinese people are going to new thing called DNA, that's principal nucleic acid, your nanobiotic technology, all these chemtrails, all these things coming to play. You don't even know real food right now. Sorry, go ahead, cameraman. I want somebody else to come and chime in. Andy, look quick before you